Service, I'm gonna let my staff take care of you to start with. I'll go from there.
Ah, thank you so much. I guess this is the old experience.
That's
the beginning of the old experience.
Ah, okay,
that's Creole stuff. So, see, this is the best time for me to bring you here, obviously, Creole Heritage Month. So,
good afternoon.
Hi,
how are you doing?
We're good, thanks.
Welcome to Orlando's Restaurant. To start you off, we want to start you off with a twist of local, where we offer you this local twist of pineapple and orange with a stick of local cane in there. And we also have cold towels for you because we know it's a bit hot out there, so we want to give you this refreshing twist of experience in here with these cold towels.
Thank you. Enjoy.
Thank you. You're welcome.
I guess this is the start of the O experience, as it says on the cool towel.
That is correct. That is just the beginning. And this is why I brought you here, because you know what? It's always a great time to come here, but for Creole Heritage Month, I know Chef Orlando is going to cook up something very special.
And so, with that said, I think this is where we welcome them to the DBX's Creative Cooking Creole Edition.
So every Sunday we are going to be taking you on a dining experience with us as we celebrate Creole Heritage Month. So everything is going to be local, it's going to be infused with Creole inspiration. And of course it's going to be even more exciting because Shanra is going to be here. So it's going to be a discovery for her, I'd like to say. And even for me. I'm not too exotic with my food, but you know when it's Creole time, it gets as exotic as you can think.
So I must say, I'm definitely looking forward to this experience. I mean, it's the first ever Creole edition, well, Creative Cooking Creole edition with DBS, and I can't wait to see what we have in store. So this week, we're kicking things off with Chef Orlando and the Big O experience. So, I hope you guys are ready because I sure am.
And you know what's gonna happen? It's about that time because we're gonna share the love with Chef Orlando.
One goal.
This is as Creole as it can get. Enjoying a drink and sugarcane chewing.
Oh gosh.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Also, we do have this wonderful twist of local. It's a local guava, green guava cup. There's some local salsa, tomato salsa in there.
Awesome,
where,
thank you.
Where you get to enjoy our local products.
Thank you, so much. This is a pleasant surprise. I didn't expect this, but
nowhere else can you find this.
Ah,
indeed. A part of the O experience, right?
Very much so.
Now, from my this looks like it has tomatoes. It has sweet peppers.
Mm-hmm.
I see onions.
Parsley.
And it's inside of a
guava. Now, wow. Can I say something really funny, guys? Do you know I don't like guava, but
you're gonna like it today.
This is something special, so let's dive right in. Let's see if Chef Orlando is gonna make me change my mind.
I think you should go first. I want to catch your reaction.
No,
so you
fair.
go first.
Jeez, okay, fine. Let's see. We're gonna discover together. Okay. I love. It's really nice. Based on what I'm tasting, the onions, the peppers, it has a nice light sauce with it. It's also not spicy, because I don't like spicy, I was worried. But it tastes really good. So, you don't really taste much of the guava in there. Thank goodness. But it tastes delicious. I like this, so.
Alright, so my turn.
No long talk.
Me, bad girl don't eat fork, so we're gonna go.
do it.
Now chew on the garlic, chew on the guava.
Oh, I can chew on the guava.
You see, I figured there was more method to this.
There's guava.
A technique.
The technique is guava. You're feeling the love in guava.
Okay, now this has a kind of spice to it.
Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. See, mm-hmm. I did it wrong.
Yeah, it's guava, so the idea is everything is edible. You're in the island, this is St. Lucia, we have the best ingredients in the world. And especially this month is all about the local. It's all about the love. So go back to the local and go flavor the love.
Okay, that's actually really good. I know you don't like
guava,
but you're gonna
try it the right way now. I'm gonna try it the right way because clearly I did it wrong earlier. So here we go.
It's the effect.
Okay. All right, so I take it back.
Mm-hmm.
This is really good, and this is coming from a non-guava lover. Everything just is such a perfect blend.
Mm-hmm. It's really nice. You know what they say, right?
Wow.
Don't knock it till you try it.
Mm. I agree.
Can I eat the leaf too?
No. Now you see, they go crazy. You see what I mean? You give me like a leaf. Fabulous. Nice idea. Get rid of the doilies and stick with banana leaves. It's local, it's a solution, and of course, you know, recyclable. So from that, we're going to take it to the kitchen and give you a flavor of banana leaves in our pan-fried fish. It's just special for Korea month.
So, Shanro. I'm thinking
what you're thinking.
Since chef's busy cooking up a storm in the kitchen.
Local cocktail.
At the bar.
Let's go.
Tropical, Creole-y, St. Lucian-y, does that make sense?
And to be on the safe side, I brought my ID. to show you that I am I'm legal. I can consume alcohol.
For sure.
Alright. So let's get this party started.
One thing, I'm not carrying you home. I'm not carrying you home.
No?
Tinusha, I'm not carrying her home.
Guys, you know where to find me. I'm on the Rodney Lake Strip. Chef Orlando, so somebody will go and pick me up, right? No, y'all got me.
I'm back.
Ooh.
Hi.
Ooh.
I got three options. Hi.
But nice. We have choices.
We got
options. I watch mine already.
Okay.
But, oh.
Wow.
Right, there we got coco melon.
Okay, I think that's right up my alley.
You enjoy.
Thank you.
So we got solution dinner right there. I think you love this one. And we got passion mojito.
We could probably share that one.
Couldn't we just have it on maybe more?
Yeah.
This is one, yeah.
You know what?
Thank you.
This was on me.
Oh!
Right. See, that's why we love Danny.
I love
Thank
Danny.
You.
Thank you so much.
So.
Woo-wee. Okay. I think a drink is bigger than I am. Or is it just me being too sure? I may just have to. Oops, maybe. Yo, that is bad. That bad isn't good. That is isn't good.
Let me try mine. So fancy.
It's something sweet.
That's great. It's true.
That. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right, this is. Okay, so this is delicious. It is refreshing, and it's exactly what I want. So thank you, Danny, because it has that little
thing. Enjoy, guys.
This is amazing. Thank you so much. So, what is it called again?
Saint Lucian Delight.
Saint Lucian Delight.
Ah, well, you see, you got exactly what you wanted.
Exactly what I wanted.
And my coco melon, I'm tasting. Is it coconut rum in here too?
Yeah, it's bond coconut.
All right, you see, so we're keeping it local, anyways,
right.
On ice.
Nice.
It's quite heavy, right?
But you know what they say. I do cheers with you. But
heavy, heavy in my tummy.
And you know what? Okay. I think we could do cheers to the start of a good afternoon.
Yes.
Orlando's.
Woo.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Yes, we got the chips.
Yes, thank you.
Here
we go.
Since he was so generous, we're going to start.
Are you ready? You know I'm short, so I just got to do the regular tip.
All right. So.
That is good.
That was good.
All right, you know what?
I really, no, I'm speechless. This is really good. A refreshing blend.
Yes, that was really good.
Well,
it tastes like St. Lucia.
It definitely does.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what I'm thinking? Right now, since I know Chef is still busy in the kitchen, guys, this is going to be a perfect time. We're going to take a quick break. Hopefully, we won't drink all of this just yet.
I'm not making any promises.
Okay, I'm not going to say any more either. You know what? Just keep watching because we'll be right back. So I could taste that good.
Yes. And imagine, I said the ones I tasted it, I tasted all. So yeah.
She did taste all. But you know, this is the funniest part because when you think of Jeanette Quayle,
mm-hmm.
that's really what it is. Because even on the day, everybody's ready to go around the island or to different spots to taste the food. And funny enough, you know what? When you think of Jeanette Quayle, that's really what it's about too, because everybody, besides the dress up, on the day you are looking forward to going around tasting the different foods. Like, you have to make room in your belly,
mm-hmm.
and you all know that, for the different sports. Who
yes.
looking for green fig and saltfish? You want pemmi, you want this. You know, one thing I always like is comfort. I know that's not really a big, big dish. It's like, you know, an after dessert kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just finding these things that you don't get to indulge in throughout the year?
I mean, knowing that I'm not a native to St. Lucia, I really look forward to this time. I think this is like my second year celebrating Juniquelo, and it just gets even more interesting every year for me. So I was really looking forward to this experience, and I think DBS doing this, you know, creative cooking quail style is definitely sealing the deal.
Well, speaking of even more interesting, I'm very certain things are more interesting right now in the kitchen. So
yes,
let's go check out what's happening, what's cooking
in the kitchen.
Welcome to Outlander's Restaurant and Bar in Rodney Bay. Of course, it's Creole month, and we're going to get a flavor of the Creole from Orlando's. And of course, some of you realize now, we've actually opened our second restaurant in Rodney Bay. So this was Orlando's at Rodney Bay. Come check us out. But of course, in the flavor of Creole, we're going to give you some simple, easy Creole fish. Now, I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with cowan. Now, of course, allow my English accent to say cowan fish, but you know what it means. Say local fish. Fresh, local, caught today. I'm going to show you a simple way of doing it. Normally, you would have it just pan-fried, a little garlic butter, a little extra love. But today, we're going to fillet the fish, and we're going to show you how to produce that in a more simple and an Orlando authentic way. Now, of course, I love your local fish. You know how beautiful it is. Now, you got to look for the eyes. If the eyes are too glossy, you'll know the fish not fresh. So you have to get fresh fish. You know, you're looking for smell. Again, we're going to take our fish. Now, of course, normally take out your guts. Now, sometimes people tend to do this fish and they have it to stick it in the freezer for a while. Make sure you clean it out before you take it in the freezer. Okay? We're going to take a knife there. I'm going to get rid of that there. I mean, of course, it's about local today. And of course, the local all month, it is about the Creole. So people don't ask me to speak patois, okay? After all these years, all I know is sacrafet and malai and no problem. And that's not English, okay? Take your fish, take a knife, follow down the side there. Make sure you keep your fingers out of the way. All the way there. And then cut your knife right there. And then put your knife and make sure you use your knife against the bone. Against the bone. Now, I know that we like to have the fish with the bones in, but you know what? It would be nice to come together a dining experience without the bones. Take a look. Your knife there, get me some more bones there. And there you have a beautiful fish. Turn over, same again. Now make sure you don't cut too deep in. Now we know, don't mind people, when you take the fillet of the fish off, you're not going to get rid of the bones, yeah? Your bones are going to make a nice stew. See? Again, keep it simple, okay, against the bone. And for all those international people watching across the world, this is island time, okay? Creole time. I know a few Creole words like sacrafet, malai, and what is that? Vini, vini, hale. Okay? Okay, good, good. Now, you all know that I love souffre, but I'm in Rodney Bay now, a little while. Along to Rodney Bay and souffre. You know, Rodney Bay is not bad. I don't see the pitons, but you know, I'm feeling the love of souffre, don't worry. Your fish, your nice bones there. So what we're going to do with that now, that's going to make a beautiful stock. Take your knife, follow along there. Now you got some, there's some bones in there. Now usually you might take a tweezer, but of course, if you ain't got a tweezer in your professional, in your home kitchen, you just run your fingers there, and you'll find your bones there. There's a few there along the side. Take it out. Because, now I gotta tell you, the reasons why I like to fillet my fish, because I like to eat fish without taking bones out of my mouth, personally speaking. But we know that, you know, that's the way we do it locally. I get it. But trust me, I think when you come to a nice expensive restaurant or a nice restaurant, you want all the work done for you. You see? And that's the idea. Take a few bones. And then now what you're gonna do with that? Take your knife from there and then hold it close and you're taking the skin off. Hold it down there. Pull it all the way back. All the way back. And there you have your skin off there. A little bit of clean up job there, as they say. You got a beautiful fish there. Again. Skin down, hold it there. Now, of course, some of you may say, oh, but you know, I haven't got a knife skill. I can tell you for sure that people do it in a crazy different way. What they may take their fish normally and stick it in the freezer for like a bit. And when it's freezer for a few seconds, about 20 minutes or so, they take a knife and pull the skin off fresh. You know what I mean? That's how we do it traditionally as well. But again, you really want to keep it simple. So clean it up a little bit, make a container. A container for that, yeah. So that's your wonderful cowan fish here, which is beautiful, locally done. Now what we're going to do now, get out there, come through. That's your fish stock. That's where you can make a wonderful flavoring from. You're going to put it into cold water with some bay leaves, some cinnamon, and also some salt and pepper, and also carrot peelings. Do not bring to boil. What you want to capture is a flavor of the fish. Bring it to boil, turn the fire off, and you got a wonderful fish stock. See? You got a wonderful fish stock. Okay. Some fish we didn't prepare earlier before, we're gonna add that to it. Guys, you know, without the Caribbean, we have to have the local flavors. I gotta tell you, don't get me wrong, people, but $2, $3. I don't want to complain to the food vendors because I love my food vendors. But $3, $3. Local ingredients are expensive here. Somehow we need to showcase how can we get our local ingredients to become more cost effective. We understand they have to go and pick it fresh. We get that. But ultimately, it is kind of like, I don't know. I will not say no more. All I can sell here, that's near $10 of seasoning there. So it's a lot, I mean, for a little bit of seasoning. But you know the Caribbean have to have a seasoning. So what we do with our local seasoning is like your local celery. Now, globally, you can go around and they call it Thai celery. You can definitely find it in Thailand. Here in St. Lucia, we use it as our local celery. But trust me, you go around to Thailand, you'll find that. Your local parsley, they're great. Scallions, or you know, they call it chives, kind of same sort of familiar. But these are what gives you a local flavor. What I've done here is a little mixture of our blend seasoning. Now, do me a favor, guys, and all you people love to cook at home, salt and pepper is not seasoning. It may be international TV, but in the Caribbean, it's just salt and pepper. Seasoning is when we add love to the food, okay? This is our seasoning. See? Our blend seasoning, our chives, our onion, garlic, everything in there. One of my local secrets I like to use, but I can share with you, look at molasses. It's really nice. And of course, I look at the international seasoning, salt and pepper. Okay, and then we're gonna add some oil. Now, of course, you gotta, as we say, as I'm on TV, I'm sharing the love with you, Creole Month, it's good. But you know, in the Caribbean, we don't do a spoon. We get inside and we work it out and season it up the fish nice and give you some love, you know? Now, I haven't added no lime to it because I don't wanna add lime. Right now, if I add lime, it's gonna sit there for too long and then break it too much. We're gonna add lime in the cooking. So anyway, we've got a nice fresh fish seasoned with love. As you can see it. And we're going to go and pan fry that and go from there. What we're going to do is a very simple pan-fried fish. We've left Pep Kitchen to come into our cooking kitchen. We've started here with a little sweet potato cake. We'll be serving our fish on that. So a bit of oil in the pan. And what we'll then do, we're going to put our fish down. Our coven. One thing for the Caribbean, one thing for Creole, is the excitement, is the experience. And of course the Caribbean and the Creole, you have to smell it. If you don't smell it, it's not the Caribbean. This is a beautiful fish, cooked very easy. Look at that. One of my biggest concerns about the Caribbean cooking is sometimes we overcook the food. A fish like this is so delicate. This is nearly cooked already. Literally a couple of minutes. So again, you're really getting the flavor of the Creole there. We'll move it around. And our fish will be serving in a few minutes. We also have now our sweet potato cake, which we're using sweet potato mash, combined with some fresh herbs, and of course a little breadcrumbs. See that fish there? Beautiful. Move it around. Beautiful. It's about the smell, it's about the flavor. Now move it around there. You know? I'm going to turn the fire off now. And while that's sitting there, that fish is cooked beautifully. Oh, look at that. St. Lucia, Creole experience. So what we're going to do now is take... Oops. We'll do our cake. Our Creole. So of course, you know, St. Lucia, without the Creole, we ain't got a Creole. So we have to have our Creole sauce. Put it right on top of there. We're going to give you a taste of Creole Month, Heritage Month, with, you know, Orlando's restaurant in Rodney Bay. And of course, you can definitely check us out in Sioux Faire. Come. It's okay, come on, chef. What we do now, we place our fish on top of that. Okay, get some green oil for me, some green oil. This is our local cowen. Keeping it simple, the avocado salsa. And what we've done, we've made a nice avocado salsa. Again, giving you a real flavor of St. Lucia. You can come to Orlando's in Rodney Bay, in Sioux Faire, Our restaurant in Sioux Falls will be reopening at the middle of October. But you can come check us out here in Rodney Bay for now. Keeping it simple. And again, it is Creole month, a flavor of the Caribbean, a flavor of St. Lucia. We're gonna take a little drizzle of our oil. The garnish. Keep it simple, keep it local. I mean, you got sweet potato mash, you got the Creole sauce, you got your Caribbean fish, you have your avocado salsa, and of course, you know, like a fresh local deal, just to give it a nice touch. Just to say that you had a flavor of Orlando's, and it's all about the cuisine. Flavor of St. Lucia, it's Creole month, enjoy those flavors. Check out our restaurant in Sioux Falls. We're opening in the middle of October. Check us out in Rodney Bay. We're open for now for dinner, but from next month we're open for lunch. We're about sharing the love, and you know, even the best kept secret, St. Lucia. Creole month for me is every month, but of course we celebrate in October. So enjoy your celebration. You got a wonderful Caribbean fish, filleted, marinated with our local fresh herbs. Served on a sweet potato cake. Sweet potato is mashed and combined with a little seasoning, and then fried. And then you've got your pan-fried fish with a little Creole sauce on the baton in between, and of course with some avocado salsa. You know, giving you a little drizzle of green oil. And again, the flavors is all about St. Lucia. This is all local. Like I told you before, it's ingredients without passports. This month is our Creole month. Of course, my opinion, every month is Creole month. But for now, we'll enjoy our celebrations in October, but every month should be a flavor of the Creole. Every month we should be trying out new ideas. Here at Orlando's restaurant in Rodney Bay, check us out. Come and share the love. So about the cuisine.
And now it's time for the taste test. Let's see how much Shandro and Sheila enjoyed Chef Orlando's Creole rendition of a pan-fried kawang sweet potato with the Creole sauce. All locally made right here in St. Lucia.
That looks so good.
Oh yes. Ooh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Enjoy. Bon appetit.
Thank you.
Merci.
That smells heavenly. No, sorry. That smells quail-y. Does that make sense?
It makes a lot of sense right now. And you know what? I wish we had Smell-O-Vision St. Lucia because it smells even better than it looks. Trust me. This is... Are you ready? Because
I've been ready.
I'm ready for this.
Do I have to use... No, I feel like I'm just going to go ahead and dig on in. Ooh. Okay. Let me see. The fish rail is right to me there.
That is good. Mm-hmm. So, a little birdie, aka Chef Orlando, once taught me that when you're gonna taste, you have to take a little sample of everything, mix the flavors up.
That way you get a true taste. So I have my fish, I have my sweet potato pie, a little salsa. All right,
here we go. The moment of truth. Wait for it.
This is so good. This is so good.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how good?
100?
I agree. Up top.
Alright. So here's to our girls' Creole lime.
Yes.
Good stuff. Chef Orlando's. Mm-hmm. Definitely scoring. Mm-hmm. And this is so good.
And you know, I just decided not to use knife and fork because I feel like the food is better when you're really comfortable.
Very much so.
This is so good. It has avocados, what we call pear in Jamaica, tasting onions, tasting tomatoes, and of course, fish.
That is very like that kawang.
Mm-hmm. I think I'm officially converted into losing an ocean.
She's not quite there yet, but at the end of this series, she'll be there. You'll get her there. Definitely. Alright. This is why I love our Creole heritage. From the dance, everything, but when you look at the food aspect, I say thank God I'm from St. Lucia.
I agree.
Yeah.
I agree.
I love how she agrees.
I have to, because, you know, this food is good. Leading up to the Quail season, I must say, guys, Chef Orlando, the O experience is the experience.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh, I can't wait for where we go next week.
You guys just have to keep watching. Keep it locked to DBS. You know already your number one leader, because we take you on this Creole dining journey. It's a food experience. So all our foodies then, all you who know, you'll look forward to your food for Je ne Creole. Keep it locked.
I put a big bit of love to you guys.
Oh.
A little love to share.
Aww. That is... How sweet is that?
A little love to share, so...
All the love.
So, thank you, Chef Orlando.
Thank you so much.
We appreciate you.
So when you come to Orlando's, you can actually share your plates. We'll give you one and you can share. We'll put two and you can share. It's all about sharing the love of Orlando's, but of course about the Caribbean experience.
Yep.
Along here in Watney Bay, we're about Creole months. Flavor of the Creole, flavor of St. Lucia, and flavor of sharing the love.
That's right. Let's see if we can figure it out.
All right, let's go to three. 1, 2, 3. Wow, I'm tasting. What am I tasting?
It tastes good.
Mm-hmm. That's for sure.
It tastes good. Okay, can we pick up the flavor?
I taste coconut.
I thought it.
Vanilla.
Okay, good. It's like a nice custard.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm feeling this is good. Like bits of coconut.
Yeah.
And Orchard, I don't think there's any more for you, sorry.
Look, this place says love, thank you, which means we have to share.
Fine.
Thank you.
Only because it's you and only because it's a quail season. Oh, well, there we go. Share the love, why don't you? Share the love. Chef, what exactly was this?
So, we had coconut.
And vanilla.
That's it, simple enough.
And simple brulee, keeping it simple, keeping it local.
Wow.
And you know what? One thing I will always mention about Creole Month, as a young person growing up in the UK, you know, my experience is about using local ingredients. What's quite important about coming to St. Lucia, you know, I've been here 20 years now, is that that special heritage about the heritage month of Creole. It's critically important that we extend it from the clothes, we do it with the dances, we do it with even a few words of the Creole, which I'm guilty of. But critically, we've got to do it with the cuisine. And we've got to get people to enjoy our local cuisine. You come to St. Lucia, you come for a flavor of the islands. And I think, especially in this month, we have make it our month. I mean, every month's our month anyway. And I really believe Creole month should be every month. But since we've taken October to celebrate Creole, we should be around the restaurant around St. Lucia, should be proud to say, I am St. Lucian, we are Creole, and we are Creole month with the cuisine.
was a very eventful day. Yes, so I can't wait to see where we go next week and what chef will be featuring.
Well, you better make room because next week is going to be just as delicious, just as much enticing. So you better make room because we have a whole month to do this.
Until next week! Oh,